But oh, there is Insa joining us from Germany as well. Insa, you have to unmute if you would like to be part. Hello. And maybe you have an image as well or a camera. And Alonso, I know that Alonso is working a lot on ocean, well, ocean protection. Well, you have to tell us maybe later on, but specifically, hello Insa, with yeah, sounds on the ocean. You have been doing big projects around the ocean as well. And I think what is the topic of our room today is really how can we make our art or our thoughts and our education available for younger people so that we can protect the ocean better. And I think that's the main goal. What is art in here? Is art something mere visual where we create more entertainment for more masses? I'm just asking this question in a provocative way. Or do we create something meaningful by getting on board scientists who really have something to say, but who until now maybe didn't have this access to the bigger civil society because it's also like a silo they are working in. Exactly like we as curators and artists, we are also working somehow in a silo. And my idea was really to merge those silos and to open up those silos and make understandable scientific ideas through the arts together with the artists for bigger population. Sounds weird, but at least for the young population, because young people, they know that the ocean is out there, even if they are not living on the ocean, but they don't know anything about ocean acidification. They don't know anything about which creatures are dying right now. They don't know anything about, for example, whale hunting in 1910 and what that has produced and how this is part of globalization and all of this. These are so topics which are so huge, but through artistic projects like this, you can really make it understandable.